But then, there is also an episode of Mahabharata in our culture. Then in that, there it is reflected, Putra Moho. Putra Moho. So it made me to again become active instead of enjoying a retired life as a pensioner. But then he is my son, Vipinal, and he established a firm as Rural India Solar Energy Private Limited. And then again I had to take responsibility of doing marketing of that firm. I wanted to get rid of from the chair, but he made me to sit again on the chair because I personally feel that this chair is the root cause of all the diseases what we have today in modern life. But anyhow, and that is what it has brought me here, because these two young guys, they want to take responsibility of training as many as people with the nominal fees, so that there are so many like-minded people like us. And if we have such like-minded people in the society, then the business of solar will boom and it will go higher. That is only our intention of training you people. That too at a very nominal fee. I came to know that for a 5-day session, yeah, we may not be having a good infrastructure like any other institute, but for a 5-day session like ours, the corporate world charges near about 36,000 to 40,000 rupees for 5-day session. Yesterday only I spoken to an owner of a training institute, Mr. Krishan Kumar Gupta in Delhi. He is running PMKVY courses. So, though it is free under PMKVY, but government pays it. Nevertheless, he is Mr. Vishnudar. Even introduce?
Yes.
Okay, he is Mr. Vishnudar, director of Lloyd Technology Private Limited. This is the premises of this company. And he only actually motivated me to start this joint venture so that we could train the people. Okay, this is my introduction. I belong to Sonipat only. Now I would like to you people to give me your introduction.
Yes,
sir.
Mechanical engineer. I am having 10 years of experience in oil and gas sector. I want to come into the renewable sector. So right now I am doing internship from National Institute of Solar Energy. And
okay, you saw our ad and then you came back to me.
Yeah, through our group, and I saw this
advertisement. Okay. So Mukherjee, I found that in your name it was written LT.
LT.
Okay, it was LT. But it was written LT. I thought it is lieutenant. So I thought, okay, there may be some lieutenant from Indian Navy, retired from Indian Navy. So I was happy to see that LP. I thought, okay, I'll find another guy from defense.
Yes. Myself, Sunil Kumar. I'm a chemical business from last 18 years.
Okay, sir.
I am interested in solar energy.
Fantastic. Your station based at where?
Delhi.
My name is Mohit Vasudeva.
Okay, sir.
I am a master's graduate from Harvard University in thermal engineering.
Thermal engineering.
I am teaching for the past 5 years as an assistant professor in Lovely Production University and afterwards Pvt University in
LPU.
I have for 2 years there as an assistant professor.
You have studied in LPU or you taught there?
I have studied in Thapar University.
And in LPU?
I have taught.
You have taught there in
LPU. For 2 years.
Okay. 2 years.
2 years, and after that, till date, I have learned law.
What is the credibility of helping you?
Credibility in the sense?
I mean, like, there are so many foreign students in LPU. Or you have come across of foreign students?
Foreign students are generally taking courses in the area of arts or, you can say, animation type.
Okay.
Or fashion designing.
Okay, nevertheless. Actually, we got a complaint against LPU. And then we have to resolve the matter, because one foreign student complained, made a complaint that LPU is not returning my fees because I left the course. That was the kind of thing. So that is why I came to know about LPU.
That is why I left
that. Okay. But I made them to return that fees. You are?
Civil engineer.
Okay, where you are special?
Panchkula. He is my younger brother.
Okay, he is your younger brother. Wait, sorry.
Myself, Praveen Rathi. I am from Bharatnagar. Okay. I am M.Tech from YMCA, manufacturing and automation. Okay. And I have been in teaching since last 12 years.
I think we can clap for everybody here.
Yeah. So, actually speaking, I am not a trainer, I am not a motivator, I am not a consultant, and what you say, I am not a thoroughly pro person like you, as I have heard from you, that what is your persona, what is your qualification. So as per that, I am not matching you, okay. But whatever I have learned in my life, those life essences I want to share with you. So here we are not teaching, we are learning from each other. It is interesting. Okay. So
you start. No, better with this.
Excuse me.
So as I told you that I am looking after the marketing of this form. His name is Rural India Solar Energy Ride Enterprise. It is in Sonipat. I'll give you my card also for your reference. So, first question is, do I qualify to be a solar entrepreneur or solar professional? First question we want to pose to each other. What are the basic qualities? Or what is that basic qualification with which I could start my own business? Because before retiring from IAF, I thought of putting that business for him. Then I spoken to so many people. And then one of the guy, he told me, okay sir, you can start for the business. Then before I got retired, we have started for him. So, our journey of starting last year and till this time, what we have found in the business, as a total layman, we had started as a total layman. We were not having any exposure of business, we were not having any exposure of startup businesses, etc. We had started as a layman. But what make you businessman is not the money, not the infrastructure, not the bank balance, and not any training. Training also doesn't make you the successful businessman. Okay. But what it makes you to be a successful businessman is that first of all, you have to be a human being. If you are a good human being, then only you can become a successful businessman. Otherwise, you keep on making piles of notes and currency and money. As I already told you that I had put an end to my earning. Right? I had decided to put an end to my earning. Why? Because I became satisfied in my life. And if you become satisfied in your life, that is all. Whether you make a business like Tata, Birla or Adani or like anyone. But what we are striving for in our life is satisfaction. That is all. We are not searching anything else except satisfaction. Satisfaction in every sphere of our life. In personal life, in social life, in business life, everywhere. What we are searching? Satisfaction. But do we have satisfaction anywhere? No. Everybody is greed of everything. So, first, let us become unity. Then we will talk business. These people will teach you what is solar, how to install, how to design, how to integrate. That thing will be taken part by these two young guys. Theoretical as well as practical. So, I would only teach you or tell you or share with you my life experience. So what is the general behavior? Avoid open expression of dislike. Avoid open expression of dislike. Which even our elder people have also told to us. In Hindi it is told that kaane ko kaana nahi kehte. Simple. Wo ye jo ek ek सेंटेंस हैं जो मैं आपसे शेयर करने जा रहा हूं, ये सेंटेंस जिंदगी में मायने रखते हैं. इट विल टेक यू टू द हाइट्स इफ यू अप्लाई द सेम थिंग इन योर लाइफ. ठीक है. आई हैव लिव्ड आई थिंक मोर लाइफ देन यू बिकॉज आई एम टुडे एट 51. एनीवन इज लेट्स गो 51. नो. सो इफ यू start expressing dislike on your face, I'm telling you, you will lose business. I had a boss who used to abuse in front of me. Not to me, but to somebody else, the third person. But in front of me. I hated that thing. I disliked that total episode. But you know what happens? If I say, what it will do, it will encourage him to abuse more. Okay. But if I say like that, then what he will do? He will spoil my career. Right? But what I did, I kept my face calm. No expression. Nothing of dislike, hatred, hate, or liking, or encouraging, nothing. I kept my face calm. And that is how I survived with that boss for another 1.5 years, whereas I hated his abuse part. So don't dislike in open. All elders are to be elders as sir. It has been my habit to address even a peon also, sir. So many people told me that you don't address, sir. In defense, there is a hierarchy level. The younger lord, young guy, we are not to be addressed as sir, as per the rank also. So when I was at a senior level, I still used to call a jawan as sir. So my peer, they used to tell me, why you calling me sir? Because it is my habit. Because I call a gentleman as sir. It is my own definition. A gentleman is sir for me. Whether he is junior to me or senior to me. Immaterial. So, they could not tell me that you don't address them sir. But they told them, the young guy, tell your boss. Tell your boss not to call you sir. Otherwise, I will raise your chassis. But I never left my junior. Okay? So I always call them sir. And that is how I earned a lot of regard and respect of my juniors in an organization, if you regard and respect and love your juniors, none of the job is there in the organization which cannot be done in time with the quality and quantity. I am telling you, this is the mool mantra. Never speak against reputation of the opposite sex. Never, never, never talk about the ladies. Derogatory remarks about the ladies. Never talk. It is not a gentleman thing. This is general behavior. It should be in your life. Then what is habit? Habit makes you successful. How? Habit is what? Do you know? Doing a thing every day, regularly, religiously, again and again. That is called habit. We can say habit, but what is habit? It is doing again and again the same thing every day, regularly. That is called habit. Even a single habit in your life, let it be anything. Let me tell you even the smallest thing. What? You get up from the bed and every day you wish your family or your elder or anyone, you avoid that habit. That also will yield in the longer term. You are brushing your teeth every day, this is also a habit, sir. So what habit does? It makes you regular and punctual in one aspect, whatever you are doing. That is habit. Okay, so adopt an habit in your life if you want to be successful. Let it be any habit. I'm not emphasizing upon a specific habit. No, let it be any habit. But for being a successful businessman, always read, time to read and study every day. That habit should be adopted by the businessman. Now track speech and conversation. Use language which expresses your thought clearly beyond any possibility of misunderstanding. What is the language? Language is mode of communication. You are expressing your own feeling to the second person by means of words. But there is also a language which earlier people used to do when language was not in existence. Language mean what? English language, modern English language, Hindi, Sanskrit, right? So, how people used to communicate? Write, describe, with the signals. That was the language, that was also language. So, what I want to tell you is that when you are speaking to someone or when you are conveying your order must be precise, beyond any doubt, beyond any misunderstanding. Your order must be so crisp, clear and to the point that recipient should not have any doubt in the mind. Once you have given the order, now I am taking you as boss of the company, okay? That you are already a solo entrepreneur. Then when you are giving order, then it should be very clear to the point. Your order and instruction to your team should be so precise and perfect so that there exists no doubt in the recipient mind. That is what I uttered earlier. Right? Now, what should be the attitude towards ladies? If in our life we understand the attitude towards ladies, then the whole society of ours will become very good. You pick up the newspaper, you watch 30-minute news article in the news, you will find 70% news are pertaining to crime against ladies. So where we are heading? Okay, so what is the appropriate behavior? We know that, yeah, we must respect ladies, but what is that respecting? We must regard ladies, but what is that regard? We must define, we should know. What is it? So, one of the established rules of the good society is that women deserve special consideration and protection. Special consideration and protection. Like, if you are sitting in a bus and if ladies are standing, we must offer the seat, irrespective of the fact that she refuses it. Don't worry. उससे आपका कहीं पे भी इज्जत या रिगार्ड घटता नहीं है. आपने ऑफर किया एंड सी डेक्लाइन, नो प्रॉब्लम, बट यू मस्ट ऑफर एज ए जेंटलमैन. एंड इफ यू आर फाउंड दैट दे आर इन डेंजर, यू मस्ट प्रोटेक्ट देम, वेदर वेदर सी इज रिलेटेड टू यू और नॉट. इमेटीरियल, डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट थिंग दैट सी इज माई रिलेटिव और नॉट. Ladies are to be respected as well as protected. But how you are going to protect the ladies? Now I want to share with you a SSB thing. SSB is Services Selection Board. So people get enrolled in defense courses by facing SSB. So their question is bold, that you are coming from cinema, your sister is with you, and then in a dark alley, some goons are stopping you and telling, hello, give me your pass and watch. What will you do? You are with your sister coming back from a theater after 9:30, and then some goons stop you and tell you that give me your watch and wallet.
There
are some. Oh, just forget, there are 4-5 guys and you are 2. Your sister and yourself, what will you
do? I will get the
same.
It depends upon what kind of a structured persons are in front of you.
I will give the real answer.
Yes, I will give the answer.
Okay, so why will you give? That is the question. That your life and prestige of your sister is more precious than a mere watch and a wallet which is containing 5,000 or 500 rupees or 50 rupees. Why? Because if you take panga with those goons and they murder you, and then there is that last night is being performed and people are going behind that what is called? And then they are talking, yeah, what happened to you? What happened to him? Then somebody will say, Dada Pagal Dada. Tell him. Arre yaar, 200 rupees de de. 200 rupees de pocket mein. 200 rupees pe jaan de. This is one aspect. Okay. But now the situation is second reason. Now you are again coming back from the theater. You are with your sister at 9:30. Now the goons are having gun. Now they are again asking you, hello, leave this lady here and go. If you want, if you think your life is endeared to you, go away from here. Then what will you do?
I protest.
How? They are having revolver and you are not having anything. What will you do? They are 5, you are 1. And you are armless. What will you do?
Then again, I will fight.
You will fight.
I have told you that depend upon the person's structure, what kind of the persons are in front of you.
I will scream for help.
Scream for help. Okay, nowadays you are seeing the TV. Nobody comes, they make the movie, you know. So what will you do?
I will fight for my sister.
I will come.
Okay. But my question is this one, that you know it very well that they are 5. Despite I fight, they are going to overpower me and then they are going to rape with my sister. We know it very well. Then, why should we fight? That is my question. We know it, that end result is this one, that they are going to rape my sister. Because they are having gun, on gun point they will rape my sister. Then why should I fight? Again, that situation comes. Why should I fight?
I cannot stand there.
cannot leave your sister there.
Same for that, I can't face my sister again in my life.
So, inner opinion towards my sister.
Okay, fantastic. So, it is the prestige. This is what called Izzat. This is what called prestige. अगर जो हम अपने लाइफ में कुछ भी करते हैं वो इसी के लिए करते हैं, इसी के लिए मरते हैं, इसी के लिए जीते हैं पूरी लाइफ. व्हाट इज दैट? प्रेस्टीज, खानदान की इज्जत या अपनी इज्जत. दिस इज कॉल्ड इज्जत. और उसी के लिए हम कमाते हैं. फॉर दैट ओनली वी बिकम बिजनेसमैन, फॉर दैट ओनली वी बिकम सैलरी पीपल, फॉर दैट ओनली वी लिव आवर विलेज, टाउन, कंट्री एंड गो एंड अर्न समवेयर एल्स. What is that? Prestige, Izzat. So, we know it very well that we are going to reap my sister. Even if I die, even if I survive, because they will overpower me. But still I will fight. Even let it be, let there be my death also. And that is the only funda word, what is told to the soldiers. हम बोलते हैं ना, सोशल मीडिया में पढ़ते हैं कि वो बॉर्डर पे जगते हैं, हम रात में सोते हैं. क्यों जगते हैं? व्हाई? ऐसे 40,000 रुपये यहाँ पे मिलते हैं, राइट ना? बट ही हैज बीन टास्क, ही हैज बीन ट्रेन, ही हैज बीन टास्क टू सिक्योर दैट पोस्ट. एंड वन मोर थिंग, लेट देयर बी एन अटैक on that border, they are not going to leave it, even at the cost of their death. Despite this fact that he knows that I am alone, and if I die, still the enemy will capture my post. But still, what he will do? He will
fight.
So, that is the thing what we were talking at the time. Why should we protect our sister? And now the another situation is there. If with me, my sister is not there, but my girlfriend is there, what will it? Why? Now I want to know the reason. Why?
I need to protect that girl.
But okay, but girlfriend you can get so many. But the problem is that one. Why should you lose your life for a girl? That is my question.
That is also
prestige. Prestige of whom? That is of yours.
Me and as well as my girl.
One second. Hello. Okay, Masi. Acha, can I hand over this phone to solar engineer? Just one second. Vipin? Himanshu ji? Actually, I am in a meeting. Can I call you after 30 minutes? Okay, sir.
Sir, call karo. Himanshu ka naam se. Solar ke bare mein puchna tha.
Okay, sir. So, इन्होंने सही बोला, वो prestige है किसी और की. तो अगर जो हमें अपनी prestige की इतनी फिक्र है, वो भी तो किसी की prestige है. हो सकता है. Now in another way to visualize this situation. हो सकता है. अब ये सिचुएशन मेरे साथ में, किसी की बहन मेरे साथ में, हो सकता है मेरी बहन किसी और के साथ में, और यही सिचुएशन हो. अगर जो वो बंदा मेरी बहन को प्रोटेक्ट नहीं करेगा तो तब क्या होगा? सो दैट इज द बेसिक फंडा ऑफ ट्रीटिंग द लेडीज एंड प्रोटेक्टिंग. दैट इज व्हाई पीपल दे थिंक इट इज नॉट माय बिजनेस, इट इज नोबडीज बिजनेस. इफ इट इज नॉट योर बिजनेस टू प्रोटेक्ट अ लेडी, देन इट इज नोबडीज बिजनेस. दैट इज व्हाई the girls are raped. Today somebody's daughter is being raped, tomorrow it may be my daughter. So we can't shoo away those responsibilities which has been tasked to us by the society. They should be shielded from unpleasant or embarrassing situations. Who? Ladies. Assisted when confronted with difficulty, and on all occasions so treated as will contribute most to their well-being and happiness. because they have been treated like that by the world. And we are the protector. But it doesn't mean I am against their freedom. We are the protector, means we have been treated by God like that, a little bit strong than
ladies.
So it becomes our duty to do not address friends, wives, or your senior person, wife as Bhaviji or auntie, please. Whether you are in corporate or in an organization or in your own company, never, never address any lady as Bhaviji or auntie, please. Okay? You can always call them either by Mrs. Anand, Mrs. Ashodhya, by Sapne, by her husband name, or by Mrs. Sunita Sharma. Understood? Never call by Bhaviji or auntie. Your behavior towards the lady should be so appropriate that your mother or sister should not feel bad about it. Simple. If you are behaving with a lady, you should also feel, kya mera behavior is lady ke saamne hai, what my mother will feel about it. Simple. If you want to understand how I should behave with the lady, simply think about it. Speak directly while looking into their eyes. Never steal glances. This I am telling you the topmost etiquettes and mannerism, which is followed by the elite class, that you will never get anywhere. So that they could build trust and confidence in you, if you are talking to them while looking into their eyes. Never steal glances. That means you are hiding something. If you are stealing glances, that means you are hiding something, or you are timid, or you are a coward. Simple.
It applies to everyone.
Yes, 100%. But since we are talking about ladies here, that is what I meant. Gentlemen, do not remain seated in the presence of ladies who are standing. Simple. These kind of culture are adopted Indo-foreign, whereas it was our prime culture in India. Now we have forgotten those culture, but foreigners, they still adopt it. Like in other countries, people, they do namaste like that with the hand folded. But we have come to what? Hi, Da, Good morning. Hey, Pa, Hey, Mo. There, in other countries, I have visited near about 4 or 5 countries. There, the people, they do like that. And it is our own Asian countries. And this culture was adapted by them from Hindus, from India. They are not forgotten. It is still there. It is still in their society. It is still existing. But we have changed our world. When walking with a lady, a man should walk on the first side. When walking with his wife, he should walk on her right. That means if she is your host wife, you walk left side. But if she is your wife, you walk to her right side. Understood? Why? You know why? No. If host wife is there or your friend's wife is there, then you are walking towards left because now she is senior and host. But if you are walking with your wife, you are walking towards right, then that means you are protecting her. And you are the boss. Okay. But they should not be taught to anybody. It should be taught to your like-minded people only. Understood? Gentleman should offer his seat to adult women, to adult women and elderly men in a public convenience. Ladies should always be served first, irrespective of the occasion, whether it is a marriage or party or buffet or whatever system is there. or office party or just gathering or just get together or friends get together, let it be anything. Ladies and children, first. Never offer your hand to a lady for shaking hand. Never. Instead, wait for them to do so. If they are offering, then you must. If they are not offering, don't extend your hand towards a lady. Not only to a lady, but I would like to assert here, to your senior also. Don't extend your hand. Until unless they are offering. And there is a way to shake hand in the life, but some people they take it like that and no. There is a way to shake hand. Like I want to shake hand with you. Now it should be form and it should be like this. But with the ladies, it should not be like this. Like with your hand, it should be like this. Just it should not be form. Okay. They should not feel your hand one. Press. Now we come to the dress. For meeting, always collar and tucked in with leather shoes. That is the funda. You go anywhere, in the office meeting, anywhere. If you are attending just office, you can wear casual. But if it is a meeting, like today we are meeting, okay, I am meeting to you, then it has to be collar and tucked in with leather shoes. Always. And it doesn't matter to what is the kimmat ka. Let me tell you that thing. Kimmat usme jo hai na maine nahi rakhti. Only think, what is your attire? What is your dress sense? That will be important. Also, inquiries are made during illness. If there is someone ill in your friend circle, in your relatives, or anyone who you are acquainted with, then you must call them or you must visit them. This is the basic courtesy in society. Calls on condolence should be shortest. If you are born for a condolence meeting, then it should be the shortest one. You go there, express yourself or just sit down and within 2-5 minutes you should leave the place. Because nobody tell you to go. You know, but there are other people are to come there. So always make a habit. Invitation are either formally or informally. Invitation are either formal or informal. Must be either answered or attended. If you have got an invitation, whether it is formal or informal, I mean official or private, it must be attended or you have to convey, I'm sorry, I can't attend. That is the habit of elite class who are in the businessman or officers or gazetted, whatever. Ethics. Now, ethics is the science of morals. Ethics is the science of morals, moral principles and rules of conduct. Ethics is the science of morals. Moral principles and rules of conduct. That is, how do we conduct ourselves? This is also ethics. Like, I conduct myself like that. I walk like this. I talk to the people like this. This is also conduct. So, how do you conduct yourself? That is also ethics. Concept of doing one's duty is central to ethics. Now we talk about ethics, so many things, but if you perform your duty, that is the central to the ethics. That means, what is ethics? Doing your own duty, always. That is ethics. You can define ethics in many ways, but doing your own duty is the integral part of ethics. I want to emphasize upon it, that it is the integral part. Now, we talk about so many things about values. But what is values? Values are principles